While you were sleeping, we got someone out of the portal. Late last night, we got a tight end transfer from Missouri, a grad transfer, Daniel Parker Jr. He just popped right in over to Fansville, brought himself a 12-pack of Dr. Pepper. And it's good to have him on the roster because, you know, we're getting a little thin at H-back tight end position, you know, at the moment for experience-wise anyway. We've lost Stogner to South Carolina. He followed Spencer Rattler over there. You know, Brayden Willis is... hasn't decided if he's going to come back yet, so that's something to keep an eye on. And also, Jeremiah Hall has graduated. So, a little thin at the H-back tight end position, but got a couple of really talented freshmen coming in, and Llewellyn and whatnot, so, and Caden Helms. So, it's just, you know, having this, that, you know, that transition, you know, where you have, like, the grad transfer while the freshmen get their feet wet, you know, really helps out the program. So, and plus it helps that when Joe John Finley was at Missouri, he worked with them for a little bit. And so he knows what he can do. And, hey, you know, I'm all about a good old-fashioned blocking tight end to open up the run game and to protect the passing game. So, but he has made a few key catches, apparently. So a game against Florida, I think it was this year, this past year, you know, caught a big pass, two-point conversion to beat them in overtime. So overall, you know, he can make the big catch if needed to once in a while. But, hey, I'm all about a big-time, you know, just a mean blocking tight end who can, you know, seal the edge and take care of business. So, overall, very happy about that. I saw highlights of the Missouri-Army game last night. Didn't watch it live, but I'm very disappointed, Missouri. You've let down the SEC. You know, we're coming into the SEC, and you've already let us down. Typical Missouri. So, yeah, overall, just not much of an update on recruiting right now. Just there's a lot of names out there, a lot of guys that we're all hoping potentially to get, you know, guys that might take a visit, and it's just, there's just a lot of sizzle out there right now, not a lot of steak. So, it's just one of those things where you just got to be patient. Like, we're creeping up to the early part of January, like guys like Javonte Barnes are going to make their announcement, and hopefully a few other dominoes will fall before then, or around that time, I should say, and then we'll be able to get things really building up for early February, the Groundhog Day, you know, one of my favorite movies. So hopefully Groundhog Day for Oklahoma this upcoming season will be fantastic, and they will, hey, you know, they have a chance to add about maybe 10 pieces to the roster, some quality ones too, by the way. So you know, still in the Devin Campbell sweepstakes, of course, and some guys from Oregon that were committed that they're kind of looking around since Cristobal took the Miami job. And of course, like, Venable's hitting Florida very, very hard. And also there's a kid he offered down here in Orlando, an offensive lineman who goes to Dr. Phillips High School, which Dr. Phillips High School is literally right behind Universal Studios Orlando. Like, you're at high school and you can see, like, the Harry Potter, like, Hogwarts stuff sticking up and everything. It's just weird because there's this big wall and all of a sudden you see, I want to go there. There's all the fun. That's what Dr. Phillips High School is, basically, when you go to South Orlando to see those things. So, anyway, just figure I'd drop in and just give my 2 cents on that. Don't know much else. Like, holidays are pretty much here, you know, for a lot of people I know are either traveling or have already traveled or going around. Did not make it home this year. Thought about it, but it just wasn't in the cards once again. But you know what? That's why we have phones. That's why we have Skype. That's why we have all these wonderful devices where we can see each other and wish each other Merry Christmas and all that stuff. So, anyway, with that being said, OU won a basketball game last night against Alcorn State as well. So I figured I'd throw that in there. Conference play starts on the 1st against K-State. Kind of a big one on the 4th of January against Baylor on the road. I think they're number one in defending national champions. Should be an easy game for Oklahoma. Porter Moser got this, you know. Groves and Harkless, they'll be just fine. Might have to do a watch along though. Let's think about that. So anyway, Boomer Sooner, you all have a great holiday season. I may pop up here and there if anything of note happens, but for now, I'm just going to sit back and enjoy these wonderful oatmeal cookies that my stepmother sent me, and I will try not to gorge on them all at once. Y'all have a good one. Boomer, I'm out.